Alex, what are we doing today?
Well, we're at home today, boys. This is gonna be a big day for us.
Got the Rory outside, got the Maybach outside, no lie, no lie. Got the Rory outside, got the Maybach outside, no lie, no lie. In a penthouse in my room, I can touch the sky, yeah, yeah. I just woke up with a dime, holding a nine, yeah, yeah. I just stuffed the back wood with a 3-5, yeah, yeah.
Yo, what is going on, guys? It is Take 10 coming at you with another video.
Today, we're on what we consider our home lake. We're wanting to bring an exciting video to you guys. Lots of pike action. In this lake, the fish don't get too big, but there's lots of them, so we're hoping to get into another double-digit day. It's our first day out together. It just opened a day ago. We got no classes today, so we came out. We're excited. We got our traditional spread. 3 rods out front of the hut, flag out far. We're kind of on a ledge here. We got our first rod up shallow. And then that gradual drop is where our center rod is, and then our far rod is right off into that deep spot. It's kind of murky today. It's not sunny. So we've got a pink Northland Tackle buckshot. We're going to go through our tackle talk today. We'll show you all of that later in the video. But we're feeling confident. We already got one in the first 10 minutes. Nothing big. It was real small. So we're ready to go. Our lines are in. It's way before 9 o'clock. It's about 8:20 right now. We're already fishing. So we're hoping to bring you guys an amazing day.
Remember your solo there, your solo.
Oh my god.
Good.
We're on the board. We are on the board. Yeah, buddy. All right, so we're back on the board. Moved spots a little bit ago. Second or third there, so we're moving rods, boys. We're moving rods. That's a sign. We just gotta keep it up, hold it out, and hopefully we keep going and find that bigger one. All right, we're back with our tackle talk today, and today we're doing our dead stick pike fishing. And what we got here, this is just an example rod I've got in my hands that's kind of rigged up and ready. We don't use this one a whole lot unless we're out with a lot of friends and family. It's a light 13 fishing combo, a lot of fun on the little hammer handles, but today when we come out a bit more serious, we want to catch some decent sized fish. We run our mediums in our spread, so we've got rods that range between medium and medium heavy outside the hut that are lined up, that are rigged and ready, and they're in the water fishing right now. But typically what I run is a fluorocarbon leader 50 pound orange label Seaguar. That's what I make myself. I'll crimp it, swivel, all of that. Or we're running 6-inch steel leaders. But it's just minnows. Minnows and little spoons that we're using out here. We keep the minnows as live as we can. We hook them right through the back and we just let them swim around above the weeds. And that's how we fish out here. So if any of you guys were wondering how we do this, that's exactly how we do it. It's been a bug.
Double up.
Oh, Alex, Alex.
Oh.
Is this? Yes, one, two, right on the ice. Okay, slow. Be careful on that edge. Good. Oh my god. Okay, rod in the water, rod in the water. Rod in the, oh my god. Okay, don't move. Yeah? Okay, okay, take it. Yeah, 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 out of breath. Easy on the. Okay, yo, you have to.
Oh my god. Oh my god. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're on our home lake. Solid 32 incher. It's not every day we come out here and get them this big. We're super excited. I make my own quick strike rigs. We get the biggest minnow in the bucket, put it down there on a flag and send her out. And this is what happens when you do that. Yeah, like I said, this doesn't happen every day, so we're really excited. I'm kind of shaking. You guys are gonna see the footage of the average size of the pike in this lake. So we're stoked. We get about one of these a season. So I'm hoping this isn't our last. I'm hoping this is our first of many this season.
Alrighty guys, we've said it once, we'll say it again, man. This has been absolutely insane today. There we go. Right there.
29 and 3/4. Yeah, this isn't a big fish lake, but you know, once in a while you get a couple big ones. So we're feeling real, real good about this one.
That fight, guys, you're gonna see it on the GoPro. That fight was insane. Like, we're not fishing like this lake, the whole lake, it's not deep, and for this thing to run like that is just unreal. Thank God we got it in, man. Right when I seen it pass the hole the first time, I was like, that's when I knew. I was shaking. I was like, okay, all right, we really got a lockdown, but here we go.
Alright guys, one thing I want to go over, we got a lot of questions about these right here. And what this is, it's plywood for flooring that you would put on, you know, cement floors. So for example, in your basement, that's what I've seen it being used for. And what I got, I cut a 12 by 12 piece here. It's got that foam, that insulation there. And I cut a V out of it like that. And so what I do is then I sand it up in here so it's not, no slivers, nothing sharp, no sharp edges for the line. And a lot of people ask, you know, why do we put these over our holes? And so this is for a couple of reasons. So you guys have seen that our rod spread is, you know, pretty far away from the hut. We spread it out somewhat evenly. And what we do is we put these over top of the hole for a few reasons. Today's windy and it's snowing, so it stops the wind and snow from getting to that water surface and freezing over. For the most part, it works relatively well, but you know, there's still that gap there. So we do get a little bit of freezing, but not nearly as much as we would if we didn't have it. The other thing that we use these as well too is it saved us a couple times when the rods come over and when they're bent over. We've actually jammed reels into that slit in there. That saved us from losing a couple combos a few times. It happened a couple years back. We had one that was vertically down the hole and we were racing to it and we got it in the nick of time. But you know, if that wasn't there, we would have lost that. So that's why we use these. It is messy when we're flinging things around, hooking in a fish, but it saves us money for sure on rods and reels. But it also helps keep that hole from freezing, which is, it's a pain when you're dealing with fish and in and out and minnows trying to swim around. So that's why we got these here. Yeah, buddy. Alright ladies and gentlemen, you're gonna see the clips here. We just finished off on a triple header. Amazing day. Quantity was not so much, but quality was right on the dot. We got a 27 here, a 23, and a 19. So, you know, big fish, we're gonna get them back. We got a little live well in here. We can show you guys on the next video how we rigged that so that these fish are not dying. We we take these clips here. So none of these fish are harmed. We got them in a little live well.
We're losing sunlight, so there's the last fish to finish this day off, and we're losing sunlight by the minute, so we gotta get these guys back.
We'll be right back.